curious and studious students of surgery. Myself, Dr. Mahesh Chaudhary. I am warm welcoming you in my surgery lecture series. This surgery lecture series contains entire surgery with anesthesia, with radiology, with orthopedic. So stay tuned with us. Let's start our surgery lecture series. Hello, dear friends. Welcome in my surgery lecture series number 37. That is the neoplasms of the rectum and the anal canal. In this lecture, we will learn the benign neoplasms like juvenile polyps, adenomatous polyps, villous adenoma, benign lymphoma, endometrioma, hemangioma, carcinoma of the rectum, its spread, the TNM system, TNM distribution, classifications of the carcinoma of the rectum, mid-rectal carcinoma, AP resection, that is the abdominoperitoneal resection, perineum resection, radiotherapy, chemotherapy, immunotherapy, Hartmann's operation, and the carcinoid tumors. All these points are covered in this lecture. So let's start. First, the benign neoplasms. The rectum shares the same type of the polyp as the colon. This has been described in detail. Only treatment of a few polyps, which are more often seen in the rectum, is described as juvenile polyps. First, juvenile polyps. It is a common rectal polyp of the children. Usually, it possesses a long pedicle and the tumor can be delivered through the anus. In this case, the pedicle is ligated and the polyp is excised. If the tumor is high up in the rectum or the pedicle is short, a snare may be used. And second is the adenomatous polyp. Lots of controversies exist regarding its malignant potentiality. As adenomatous polyp detected, it should be removed. In case of sessile adenoma, removed either by the submucous dissection per annum or the tumor may be fulgurated with an inserted electrode pass through a sigmoidoscope. Dear students, you can see a good picture on your screen. That is the adenomatous polyp of the rectum. Here is another image, first showing the MRI image of the adenomatous polyp. Second image is the same adenomatous polyp. Here is a juvenile polyps. In this image, you can see there are four images. This is the CT images of the villous adenoma. You can see on your screen, this is the same villous adenoma of the rectum and anal wall, anal canal. Now the villous adenoma, as we see in the image previously, this tumor is often very large size and is a precursor of carcinoma. Tumor has a fern-like appearance. This tumor discharges mucus and rarely it is so profuse, which is high in potassium as to cause electrolyte imbalance and fluid loss. Transanal endoscopic microsurgery, that is the TEM, has a very helpful for local removal of villous adenoma through the anal canal. In this method, a large operating sigmoidoscope is introduced. The rectum is distended with CO2, that is the carbon dioxide, in suppletion in the anal canal, in the rectum. The image of the operation field can be displayed on the monitor through a camera inserted via the sigmoidoscope. The lesion is excised with specially designed instrument observing the monitor screen. This is a highly specialized technique. Now, next is the benign lymphoma. It is essentially a submucosal lesion but appears as a nodule which is firm and rather mobile. The color is pink to grayish white. No age is exempted and it involves both sexes almost equally. Treatment is local excision. And second is endometrioma. It is usually involves female of 20 to 40 years of age and occasionally at the menopause. A submucous tumor which appears as a constricting lesion at rectosigmoid junction. Diagnosis is not difficult as dysmenorrhea with rectal bleeding is the only peculiar symptoms of this condition. This is the benign lymphoma image on your screen you are watching. Benign lymphoma. Second image is the benign endometrioma. You can see clearly on your image, there is the endometrioma is seen. Now the treatment, contraceptive pill which inhibits ovulation and amelioration of symptoms. If this fails, then bilateral oophorectomy will cause regression of the lesion. Local resection is usually not necessary. Now next is the hemangioma. This is an uncommon tumor. Is usually localized in the lower part of the rectum or upper part of the anal canal. Bleeding per rectum is the only symptom. Treatment is extensive excision of the rectum and anal canal bearing the lesion. Anterior resection of sphincter conserving operation is well suited for this purpose. Here is a picture of the hemangioma of the CT scan. You can see another color picture by the sigmoidoscope, colonoscope taken, hemangioma of the anal canal. Now the carcinoma of the rectum. First pathology, precancerous condition, that is the Wheeler's papilloma, adenomatous and familial polyposis. These are the precancerous conditions of the carcinoma of the rectum. Then macroscopic types, proliferative varieties, which is common in rectal ampulla. Second is the ulcerative variety. It is also seen in the ampulla of the rectum. And third is the annular or tubular variety, which is more often seen at the pelvic rectal junction or anorectal junction. And then, dear students, here is the images of the carcinoma of the rectum and anal canal. This is the another images of the anal canal carcinoma. Now, the microscopic varieties. Microscopically, all rectal carcinomas are basically columnar cell adenocarcinoma. Three varieties of the adenocarcinoma can be seen according to their differentiation. First, well-differentiated variety. Second is averagely differentiated variety. And third is the anaplastic or undifferentiated varieties of the microscopic varieties of the carcinoma of the rectum. B is the coloid carcinoma. In only small percentage, it may appear either from the mucoid degeneration of the adenocarcinoma or as a primary mucoid carcinoma. Grows rapidly, metastasis early and passes a poor prognosis. C is the squamous cell carcinoma, usually due to invasion of anal canal, anal carcinoma extending up into the rectum. Now, the spread. Spread by the local spread and lymphatic spread, venous spread, transperitoneal spread. First, local spread. The peculiarity of the direct infiltration of rectal carcinoma is that it usually occurs circumferentially. Spread involves mucous and submucous coats. Gradually, the growth spreads deeply to the muscular coat. Growth takes a long time to penetrate fascia propria. Anteriorly in males, prostate and seminal vesicles and the bladder. In females, the vagina and the uterus. Laterally, uterus may be involved causing secondary hydronephrosis. Posteriorly, the sacrum and the sacral plexus nerves may be involved. Then the lymphatic spread. Lymphatic spread is quite early. As soon as muscles of the rectum are involved, choice of lymphatic spreads. The peculiarity of the lymphatic spread of rectal carcinoma is that the spread is mainly upwards as the lymphatic move mainly in that direction. Venous spread, like others carcinoma of the body, spread through blood occurs late. The first organ to be affected by the venous spread is the liver through inferior mesenteric vein. Transperitoneal spread. If rectal carcinoma situated at high up in the rectum, above the peritoneal reflection, peritoneal metastasis may occur. Now the staging of the carcinoma. Clinical staging of rectal carcinoma is important to find out how far has the disease progressed and what should be the line of treatment histologically. Grading indicate the type of the carcinoma. Two types of clinical stages, that is the Duke's classifications and TNM system. First, Duke's classification, stage A, the growth is limited to rectal wall. Stage B, the growth has extended beyond the rectal wall but no involvement of the regional lymph nodes. Stage C, the growth has extended beyond the rectal wall and the regional lymph nodes are involved. This stage can be further subdivided into stage C1, where the local pararectal lymph nodes are only involved, and stage C2, where the intermediate and the main nodes are involved. Now, the TNM system, T1S, that is the carcinoma in situ. T1 means involvement of the mucous and submucous coat, but the muscular wall is not involved. T2 means the involvement of the muscular wall judged by induration on palpation. T3 means the involvement of the all layers of the colonic wall including serosa, which is judged by the irregularity. T4 means the extension to adjacent structures. N0, no lymph nodes metastasis. N1, regional lymph nodes involved. Then M0, no distant metastasis. M1, distant metastasis is present. These are the TNM system of classification of the neoplasms or carcinoma of the rectum. Now the histological grading, that is the broader classification, the more nearly the tumor cells approach normal texture and shape, the less malignant is the tumor. Conversely, the greater percentage of the cells of embryonic nature with lots of mitosis and the tumor is of undifferentiated variety and virulently malignant. Stage 1, low grade, well differentiated and good prognosis. Stage 2, average grade, fair prognosis, and grade 3, stage 3 is the high grade and anaplastic tumors, that have the poor prognosis. Now the clinical features. As other carcinomas in the body, rectal carcinoma is a disease of old age. If it occurs in younger age, the prognosis is poor. The patient usually does not come to the doctor before 6 months of the commencement of the disease. Now the symptoms. The main symptom is a bleeding per rectum, mucus along with bleeding. Second is the alteration of the bowel habit, either increased constipation or early morning diarrhea. This is the particular symptom seen in the cauliflower growth of the ampulla of the rectum. Sense of the incomplete defecation. When a papilliferous or proliferative growth is situated at the lower half of the rectum, next in symptoms is the intestinal obstruction. Presenting symptoms in the stenosing growth. Next, pain. The late symptoms, colicky pain from the intestinal obstruction, bizarre symptoms like loss of weight, palpable lump of the liver metastasis, yellowness of jaundice and abdominal distension from ascites. Now, the rectal examination should be performed, that is the mandatory, is very important, and 90% of the rectal carcinoma can be failed digitally. So, all cases of slight rectal problem should be examined by the digital examination to exclude the carcinoma. Typical indurated fill, bimanual palpation for higher growth even at rectosigmoid junctional growth. In females, one finger in the rectum and another in the vagina will give a good idea about the degree of the infiltration of the carcinoma of the rectum. Now the special investigation is to be done in this condition, that is the proctosigmoidoscopy will reveal the growth and the taking biopsy. Second is the biopsy. When a growth is detected through proctoscope or a sigmoidoscope, a biopsy must be taken from the edge of the tumor and also from the central part of the tumor. Histological diagnosis is more important and it will also detect the histological grading, which is essential to know the prognosis and for the proper treatment. And next investigation is the bare minimum. It should be always performed even when a carcinoma is detected in the lower part of the rectum. Now the fourth investigation is the endorectal ultrasound in the rectal carcinoma, that is also called ERUS, endorectal ultrasound. Endorectal ultrasound, ultrasonography has revolutionized the management of the rectal cancer. CT and MRI may detect the extensive of tumor beyond the rectal wall or involvement of the adjacent structures. And the fifth investigation is the colonoscopy, the best method to exclude only lesion higher up in the colon. Now the treatment. Like the cancers anywhere in the body, radical resection is the only curative treatment available for the carcinoma of the rectum. Radical excision means is excision of the rectum with its sheath along with all nodes lying on the wall with 5 cm normal tissue above and below the growth and all involved regional lymph nodes. Obviously, if the main nodes are involved, the only way to the radical surgery is to ligate inferior mesenteric artery at its origin from the aorta, that is the flush ligation. Next is the proximal rectal carcinoma. Low anterior resection and primary anastomosis conserving the sphincter mechanism. In young whom carcinoma growth rapidly, the AP resection to avoid the recurrence. So, this procedure is to be done in the proximal rectal carcinoma. Now, the picture is showing on your screen is the sphincter conserving operation using EE8 stapler for anastomosis after resection of the mid rectal carcinoma. Now, for the mid rectal carcinoma, the principles of the surgery are AP resection will be safest, permanent colostomy has to be avoided, AP resection pull through operation and making the anastomosis outside the anus to avoid the problem of doing an anastomosis deep in the pelvis. Proximal colon is drawn to the anorectal stump and is sutured to the inverted anorectal stump outside the anal canal. Now available a stapling instrument, the EEA stapler, that creates an involving end-to-end anastomosis. This has made it technically possible to rest mid-rectal carcinomas down to the distal limit and to restore continuity by a safe and end-to-end anastomosis. Now here is a good picture showing the total mesorectal excision for the mid-rectal carcinoma. Very good picture is showing all the anatomy and the carcinomatous position. Now for the distal rectal carcinoma, the principle of the surgery is to be adopted for is AP resection, Miles or Perino abdominal resection, Gabriel is the method of the choice in distal rectal carcinoma. Preoperative preparation in this condition, in this operation, colon and rectum should be devoid of any fecal matter and bacteria, easily achieved by mechanical cleansing and antibiotic treatment, liquid diet, purgatives, enema or whole gut irrigation. Antibiotics against both aerobic and anaerobic organisms is to be given. If electrolyte imbalances, should be corrected and catheterization.
are the preoperative preparation of the for the surgery of the carcinoma of the rectum. Now, dear students, here is a good pictures of the resection of the colon and colostomy step by step. There is a carcinoma at the distal rectal distally of the rectum and cancer, and nearby the tissue is removed up to the sigmoidocolon, and then colostomy is to be done and colostomy bag is put there. Now the AP resection and anteroperineal resection, abdominoperineal resection. This is radical operation and was advocated by the Miles in the 1910. The bowel with the growth along with the surrounding healthy tissues and involved lymph nodes are removed. Following structures to be removed, the anal canal, external sphincter muscles with a wide area of the perianal skin, the whole of the rectum with its surrounding fasci and AP and pararectal groups of lymph nodes, adjoining part of the pelvic floor and the peritoneum, and three quarters of the pelvic colon along with its lymph nodes of the mesocolon. Post-operative treatment, foot end of the bed raised to relieve pressure of the pelvic floor, colostomy and wound should be inspected daily to look for its variability. Now the radiotherapy in the CA of the rectum and post-AP resection. Some adenocarcinoma now respond to radiotherapy. Some larger cancer may shrink to make removal easier. Preoperative radiotherapy 2000 rats in 2 weeks may be given. Now the chemotherapy for the CA of the rectum, the efficacy of the chemotherapy is very much questioned. The most frequently used drug is the 5-fluorouracil, that is the 5-FU. 5-FU plus levamisole may slightly improve survival compared combination. Now the immunotherapy, particularly in the treatment of the disseminated colorectal cancers, various monoclonal antibodies to carcinomembranic antigen have been used to destroy the cancerous cells. But these antibodies are not sufficiently specific and they also damage normal tissue. Immunotherapies with agents such as interferon alpha-2A monoclonal antibody 17-1A and autologous tumor vaccines, all these agents is used in the immunotherapy. Now the next point is the Hartmann pouch. The Hartmann pouch, Hartmann's operation. This is an excellent procedure in old man and in a person who may not stand an abdominoperineal resection. Through an abdominal resection, the rectum is excised. Like radical resection, the remnant of the rectum is closed by the suturing and the peritoneum is overseen. The pelvic defect is covered in the usual way. The cavity below and can be drained through the anus, which is divided posteriorly. The proximal end is taken out as a permanent colostomy. As cancers in these patients spread slowly, this operation works well. Dear students, here is a good picture of the sigmoid colonic cancer, and for the dotted line showing the removal part of the colon, and there is a distal pouch of the Hartmann's is to be made and for the permanent colostomy. Here is the next stage of the picture. Hartmann pouch is clearly seen and there is a percutaneous permanent colostomy is seen. The same picture is showing the Hartmann's operation, Hartmann pouch. Now the extensive operation. When carcinoma of the rectum has spread to adjacent organs, the radical operation can often be extended to remove these structures. In the males, total colectomy and a resection of the rectum may be performed. Urinary diversion in the form of ileal conduit is made. In the females, a total hysterectomy may be performed along with the excision of the rectum. Pelvic evisceration, that is the Brunswick's operation, the patient is in lithotomy Trendelenburg position. All the pelvic viscera together with internal iliac and obturator groups of the lymph nodes are removed. In the process, internal iliac arteries are ligated. Some form of the urinary diversion is performed. Now the result, in specialized centers, overall 5 years survival rate after surgery is approximately 50%. In these centers, resectability rate is high as 95% and operative mortality is less than 5%. Histological grade is very much influences the outcome. One point should arouse interest that with the more frequent use of the sphincter saving resection compared with the abdominoperineal excision, survival has not been affected. So always surgeon should try to save for the sphincteric muscle or avoid to sphincter resection in this condition. Now the next point of this lecture is the carcinoid tumor. This tumor has been described earlier, is usually remains in the submucous coat and the mucous membrane over it remains intact. It appears as a small plaque like elevation. Slow in progression, this carcinoid tumor is a slow in progression and very less metastatic. Now the treatment is
the excision of the rectum, and even when metastasis is present and resection prolongs life. Dear student, there are good videos on YouTube, that is the Hartmann's operation, AP resections for the carcinoma of the rectum. You can watch it to clear your concepts. Now here is the end of our surgery lecture number 37, that is the neoplasms of the rectum and anal canal. Thank you, students.